What's up, guys? It's Endymion, and today I want to talk about one of the books that was released for Mass Effect Andromeda, and the horrifying discovery of something that would have forever changed the face of the Andromeda Initiative forever, and how something so devastating could be replicated and used to topple the New Galaxy Order after the Reaper invasion in Mass Effect's future. Today I want to talk about the Fortinbras virus from Mass Effect Andromeda Annihilation. Obviously, spoilers for the novel Annihilation. Let's begin. Annihilation tells the story of one of the Andromeda Initiative arcs named Kila Sia, which in the Quarian native tongue means by the homeworld I hope to find one day. This particular arc is on its way to Andromeda and houses multiple races instead of the more advanced Initiative arcs, each specializing to one particular race, such as the Hyperion being the human arc. The Kila Sia holds the Batarians, Drell, Elcor, Hanar, and Volus, alongside the Quarians being the chief engineers and pilots of the vessel overall. The ship is also designed like most Quarian vessels in that it can be a habitable environment to live on, like other Quarian vessels in the past, since the Quarians lost their homeworld to the Geth all those years ago. Anyway, one day, during a routine check on the citizens in cryosleep, it's discovered that there were actually dead bodies in cryosleep, Drell to be specific, plagued with some sort of infection of unknown origin. The ship's captain, Quetzi, a Quarian who's in charge of the entire ship, is joined by other various experts from the other races to find out just what the hell is going on exactly on the Kila Sia. The virus is named the Fortinbras Plague by the Elcor throat specialist, Yorick, who, like his name suggests, is a big-time Shakespeare fan. The plague is tested and found that one of the main properties of the virus is the Volus race-specific virus known as Yoktan, which is similar in form to chickenpox in humans. The plague also has properties of Asari cyanophage, which is basically the Asari version of HIV. Yikes. It also has properties from Aeolon B, which is a Solarian-made virus similar to syphilis, and the virus has properties to another disease named Titan's Tears, which is a brain hemorrhaging fever that affects Turians. Man, this does not sound fun to get at all. As if that wasn't bad enough, the virus also has properties from the Drell's Kepler syndrome, which, as we all know, Thane Krios suffered from. And to top it all off, the virus also has traces of chemicals found in the Asari-born Ardat Yakshi, which we know is a bad thing, cause, well, crewmate Samara from Mass Effect 2's kids are all Ardat Yakshi, and they are basically Asari who, when they get busy with another person, end up brain hemorrhaging their partner's mind into utter oblivion, killing them. So yeah, Fortinbras Plague is like if the coronavirus got drunk, slept with a bunch of STDs, got a lap dance from an Ardat Yakshi, and topped it all off with basically a brain aneurysm with that Titan fever stuff. Fortinbras is super cancer, basically. But it's nothing a little ginger ale and Campbell's chicken noodle soup can't fix, am I right, Canadians? moving on. The virus in the beginning of the novel has no clear origin as to who did it or why, but it causes sores to appear on the infected's body, and after it progresses, it causes the body to form fistulas, which are basically abnormal connections between two points, like intestines, blood vessels, or your butt. Man, this virus sounds serious. Well, to get to the meat of this topic, it's eventually revealed that the Fortinbras was brought on board the Kila Sia by dun dun dun, its own Captain Quetzi. How could you? We trusted you. But it turns out the real reason Quetzi brought this absolute banger of a cocktail of bad ideas on board was that Quetzi, a radical Quarian purist, believed that in order for the Quarian people to flourish in a new galaxy, it would be impossible as long as the more prominent alpha races were present, like the Turians, Asari, Solarians, and humans. So, the virus was designed to show no symptoms, in theory anyways, amongst the various passengers of the Kila Sia, so that when the Ark reached the Nexus, the passengers would wake up, have a nice cup of coffee, and spread the Charlie Sheen virus to all the more powerful races in hopes that it would utterly devastate and wipe out these alpha races so that the Quarians, as well as the other lesser council races like the Elcor, Hanar, Batarians, Drells, could rise up in a new galaxy completely free of the baggage and rules of those who hold more political and military power over these races way back in the Milky Way galaxy. Obviously, once this is discovered, everything has gone to hell. People are dying, even our Shakespearean-loving Elcor friend Yorick is infected, and being a badass Elcor, because Elcors are cool as hell, Yorick is able to create a retrovirus cure for the disease by using the DNA of the one person immune to the virus on board, which is dun-dun-dun, our own Captain Quetzi. Sneaky, sneaky. Eventually, what ends up happening is Captain Quetzi, realizing what she did was wrong, which I mean no S-H-I-T, Sherlock, Quetzi takes the retrovirus, injects it into herself, and strips herself of most of her Corian protective environmental suit, since the retrovirus needs a host to make physical skin-to-skin contact in order for the cure to work. And Quetzi goes from one infected individual to another, from race to race, which, by the way, in this ship, each race needs specific climates for them to live in. So the ship is vast in its diversity, with the Drell area being different than, say, the Elcor's habitat, which, since the Elcor are so huge, they don't even sleep in stasis pods, but more like a cryostasis garage, basically. And Quetzi, eventually redeeming herself for what she's done, dies once she cures the Volus passengers who were infected due to the retrovirus attacking her immune system. Since Corians, as we know, get sick incredibly easily due to their pathetically weak immune systems due to living in their suits. Ultimately, only two people are left with the knowledge of the virus on board in the Kilisea in its aftermath, and they both vow to never tell the Nexus of its origins or whatnot in fear of the repercussions it would bring to the races aboard for harboring such a dangerous virus specifically targeted at the rest of the initiative. In terms of Mass Effect 4, this virus could easily be replicated, and as far as we know, the now dead Corian Captain Quetzi had support from outside in delivering and creating this super plague in the first place. And where are those people now? Are they still in the Milky Way galaxy? Let's not forget that after the Reapers have been defeated, there are millions of dead Reapers just drifting in space, each containing the genetic material of alien races long forgotten. And what sort of properties or diseases did these millions of races suffer from before? What if the mystery people who made the Fortinbras plague got a hold of a little Inusanin DNA, or maybe some other race, like a Rachni-like bug race? What kind of plague or virus could they make from those discoveries? This revelation of a plague that could have systematically wiped out every Alpha Council race in a matter of days is terrifying, and it could and probably is still out there. That's scary. Well, guys, that's the story and possible theory of the Fortinbras plague, the Super Saiyan of viruses, basically. What do you think of something deadly like this returning? Or would BioWare not include something like this out of fear of how the public will react to the comparisons between this and you know what that has been plaguing us for almost 2 years at this point? Let me know in the comments below. And if you like what you've seen and you want to see more, please like and subscribe to help a new YouTuber out. I'm Endymion. Wash your hands or the Fortinbras plague might come and roundhouse kick you to death. And make sure to check under your bed for Corians looking to start an uprising. Yes, I know, I'm stupid and cringe. Anyway, thanks for watching. I will see you in the next one.